Hey guys, Gixerman01 here on YouTube. Today we're going to do a little video called What's in My Bag. So we're going to go over my camera gear, the different lenses I have that I use to shoot my YouTube videos and do some of my photography projects. So let's just dig into What's in My Bag. Okay, we have my Nikon D800 full frame 36 megapixel DSLR. I love this camera. It took me a while to get used to shooting with it. I came from a Canon T4i, which was a pretty simple camera, and it literally took me about 20 minutes to take a picture with this thing. It can be kind of complicated, but it is a phenomenal camera. It was the flagship Nikon there for a couple years. They also had the D4, but that was more for sports, where this is more for just standard portraits. And this thing is just phenomenal. Couldn't ask for a better camera. And then my go-to lens is a Tamron 24-70 2.8. I originally looked at buying the Nikon 24-70 2.8, but it didn't have image stabilizations. And I didn't think it was a huge deal, but I'm really glad that I made this choice instead of buying the Nikon. Although the Nikon's been considered the holy grail of 24 to 70s for quite a while, but I'm thrilled with this. It, you know, a lot of the reviews ranked it as good as the Nikon, so I can't complain. Again, it's just a great lens. And then next up here is my 28mm 1.8G, the G meaning that it's has no aperture ring, external aperture ring. Great lens, gives great bokeh, good piece of glass. I bought this when they first came out. I was looking for a 24 to 2.8, but kind of stumbled onto this by mistake and was actually glad I did. It's not quite as wide as that 24, but it suits my purposes. It's a great lens. And then next we have the Nifty 50. I don't think anybody's bag is complete unless you got a 50mm lens. If you're shooting on a DX camera, you definitely need a 50mm lens when you're shooting video. That seems to be the go-to lens for video on a crop sensor. That's the equivalent of about I'm gonna say it's a 75mm on a crop sensor lens or on a crop sensor camera, and so that's what a lot of people use shooting their videos. But I love mine. It's again another camera or another lens with that great bokeh. And then this is my 85mm. Although I use my 24 to 70 to shoot most of my stuff, this 85 on my full frame camera shooting video is phenomenal. The video, you know, real cinematography out of that lens. Then next is my 70 to 300 4.5 to 5.6G. It's an okay lens. If you're shooting way out there, you definitely got to crank that shutter speed to stop from getting some blur. I'm just not that steady. But if I put it on a monopod and I shoot with this, it's not too bad. In crop sensor mode, you get the equivalent of a 450mm lens. So it really does let me get way out there, but it's not real great at gathering light. So you got to have a bright day to do that. Next up is my grip. Lets you use 8 AA batteries, and when you do that in crop sensor mode, it lets you get an extra frame per second. Not much else to say about that. It's a Chinese knockoff, by the way, and this is my Chinese knockoff speed light. It's everything that a Nikon SB900 is, except it's about a third the price. I think the SB900 is about $650 to $700, and this thing was about $190 for this flash. The difference is too is that this one doesn't overheat, so Great flash. I don't use it a whole lot, but when I have, it's performed flawlessly. And then this little gem is my P7700 Prosumer point and shoot. I say point and shoot, but it'll do everything a DSLR will do, except you can't change lenses. Although it has the equivalent of a 24 to 70 or 270 millimeter lens built on, and it goes down to f2. So great camera. You can get good bokeh with a point and shoot. And then the main reason I purchased this camera, because it had microphone input, and you just don't see that on these cameras. So this is a great camera for shooting video, and actually a lot of the video you've seen on here was shot with this. This video is shot with my D800, but all the lenses videos were shot with my P77. And this is an LED light that I picked up on eBay. It really comes in handy. And then this is a new little toy I got, and it's a desktop dolly with a magic arm. And so you've seen those nice little roundy pans that I did on the lenses, and this is how I did it. It's like $10 on Amazon, I think it was. And then I have a Revelli professional grade tripod with a Manfrotto pistol grip ball head on it. It's probably the best tripod head you can get. And then next is my little Rocketfish tripod and a Rocketfish monopod with a custom made camera mount on it that really comes in handy with that 70 to 300 lens. And then a nice heavy duty selfie stick that I can put that P7700 on and use it. So that's what's in my bag, baby. Thanks for watching my video.